Hello students, I am Manohar from KAP, your maths teacher. Now I introduce the new chapter in 10th standard mathematics, relations and functions. The first chapter also. This chapter deals with linking pair of elements from two sets and introduce the relation between the two elements in the pair. You understand? The chapter deals with the linking pair of elements from the two sets and the introduce relation between the two elements in the pair. In our day-to-day life, we have known the term relations in a pattern, such as the relation between brothers and sisters, husband and wife, or teacher and student. In mathematics, the form relation is used to relate the numbers, symbols, variables, sets, group of sets. Okay. For example, capital A is a subset of B, denotes the relation of capital A and capital B. Now, before we start learning about the relation function in class 10th, we introduce a great mathematician, Gottfried Wilhelm Leibniz. He also known as von Leibniz. He wrote extensively on 26 topics covering biology, psychology, engineering, sociology, ethics, history, law and music theory, etc. Leibniz is hailed as the father of applied sciences. Leibniz provided the foundations of a formal logic and a Boolean algebra, which are fundamental of modern day computers also. In this chapter, to learn, define and determine Cartesian product of sets. To define a relation as a subset of Cartesian product of sets. To understand function as a special relation also, to represent a function through an arrow diagram, a set of ordered pairs, a table, a rule or a graph. To classify function as one-one function, many-one function, onto function, into function and bijection function. To study combination of function through composition operation. To understand the graphs of a linear, quadratic, cubic and reciprocal functions also. In class 9th, we have studied the concept of sets. We have also seen how to form the new sets from the given sets by taking union, intersection and complementation. So, we are learnt about some basic concept of set. Right. What do you mean by set? We already learned in the 9th standard, first term. Anyone? Okay. A set is a well-defined collection of objects. Understand? A set is a well-defined, understand that word, well-defined collection of objects. Well-defined means that given any object, it must be clear. It must be clear whether that object is a member of the set. Example, a set of natural numbers. Okay, the collection of natural numbers, capital N. Another one, a set of vowels of the English alphabet. Okay, A, E, I, O, U. Next one, a set of days of the week, Sunday to Saturday. Okay, okay. Next one, not well defined object means. What do you mean not well defined? For an example, collection of good books in our library. You understand or not? Yeah. Collection of good books means we don't know about what are the good books. Okay. So something confusing. So these like elements are called not well defined objects. So a set is a well defined collection of objects. In this chapter, relation and functions, we discuss about some important two things. The first one is ordered pair. Ordered pair. Pair means two numbers. And Cartesian product of A and B. A set and B set. Very simple thing and easy thing also. Now, what do you mean by ordered pair? Something like, we are in auditorium or a cinema theater. There are more lines. The seating plan in auditorium and theater. Some seats, tickets are given to you. On the tickets, the numbers are given like an ordered pair only. 1,5, 7,16, 3,4, 10,12. What are the meaning of the 1,5, 7,16? Very simple. The person who gets 1,5 will go to first row and occupy the fifth seat. Okay, that means 1,5. So something link about the two numbers. A ordered pair is a set of inputs and outputs and represent a relationship between the two values. Listen very carefully. A ordered pair is a set of inputs and outputs and represent a relationship between the two values. Now we start about to learn about Cartesian product. What do you mean by Cartesian product? Now see the one example. Let us consider the following two sets. A is a set of three vegetables and B is a set of four fruits. Okay. See, vegetables, A set is vegetables, B set is fruits. Carrot, brinjal, lettuce finger and B set is apple, orange, grapes and strawberry. Or simple thing, what are the possible ways of choosing a vegetable with a fruit? You understand or not? Okay. What are the possible ways of choosing a vegetable with a fruit? A simple thing. The possible ways of choosing vegetable with a fruit. So now, the input the values of in arrow diagram. In the first arrow, the arrow diagram is, first one is vegetables, the second arrow diagram is fruits. Now, carrot, brinjal, lady's finger, and the other set is apple, orange, grapes, and strawberry. Now, choose a vegetable with a fruit. Now, I take the carrot. So, carrot to with a fruit. So, first one, carrot to apple, carrot to orange, carrot to grapes, carrot to strawberry. Next one, brinjal to apple, brinjal to orange, brinjal to grapes, brinjal to strawberry. The last one, lady's finger. So lady's finger to apple, lady's finger to orange, lady's finger to grapes, lady's finger to strawberry. We can select them in a 12 distinct pairs as given below, like C, A, that means carrot and apple. So C, A, own pair. Another one, carrot, orange. Another pair, carrot, grapes, carrot, strawberry. Like brinjal with four things and lady's finger to four things. This collection represents a Cartesian product of the set of vegetables and a set of fruits. So these are called Cartesian products. A small definition to you. What is Cartesian product? Or define Cartesian product. An important question for you. A two more question. A Cartesian product means if A set and B set are two non-empty sets. So already we learned about the one other example for you, vegetables and fruits, two sets. So one is vegetables, another one is fruits. So it's a non-empty sets. If A and B are two non-empty sets, then the set of all ordered pairs A comma B, a ordered pair, such that A belongs to capital A, B belongs to capital B, is called the Cartesian product of A and B and is denoted by A cross B. Thus A cross B is equal to open set bracket A comma B such that A belongs to A and B belongs to B, the closest set bracket. So again, the definition is very important for you. If A and B are two non-empty sets, Then they set off all ordered pairs A comma B such that A belongs to A, B belongs to capital B, is called the Cartesian product of A and B, and is denoted by A cross B. Thus, A cross B is equal to set bracket A comma B such that A belongs to A comma B belongs to B open set bracket. The Cartesian product is also referred as a cross product. Understand very well. The Cartesian product is also referred as cross product. Now, let A set is 1 comma 2 comma 3 and B set is A comma B. Write A cross B and B cross A. Okay, understand? A cross B and B cross A. Find A cross B and B cross A. Simple thing. First one, A cross B. One by A cross B, so A set into cross B set. What is A set? 1, 2, 3 cross A, B. Now, using the Cartesian product, write the answer. What is the Cartesian product? A comma B set of, write the set of ordered pair only. Write the set of ordered pair only. Like A comma B, like A comma B set. Ordered pair also. So, first you take the first number is a 1. 1 to the another set B set is first number A. So 1 A. So 1 comma A. Now 1 into B. So 1 comma B. Next one, the second number is 2. So 2 comma A. And then 2 comma B. Third number 3. 3 comma A. 3 comma B. Okay, good. So the 6 sets are here. Next one, B cross A. So what is the B set? A comma B. What is the A set? 1 comma 2 comma 3. The same Cartesian product, write the set of ordered pair. Now take the A, element of A, to first number, A comma 1. Now again, take A to second number, A comma 2. Again, take A to third number, A comma 3. Now, in the first set, second number is B. So take the B to first number, B comma 1, B comma 2, B comma 3. So again, the 6 sets are given. When will A cross B is equal to B cross A? It's a very simple thing. Where the A set is and B set is equal, the same equal sets. Like A set is a 1, 2, 3 and B set is a 1, 2, 3. The equal sets are given when the A cross B is also equal to B cross A. But the above example is A cross B is not equal to B cross A. Okay. Good. In general, A cross B not equal to B cross A, but N of A cross B is equal to N of B cross A. A cross B is equal to null set, 0, empty set, if and only if capital A equal to null set or B equal to null set. A cross B equal to null set if and only if A equal to null set or B equal to null set. Third one, if N of A equal to P and N of B equal to Q, then N of A cross B equal to P into Q. Now we are going to example 1.1. If A equal to 1 comma 3 comma 5 and B equal to 2 comma 3, then first one, find A cross B and B cross A. Second one is A cross B is equal to B cross A. If not, why? Third one, so that number of A cross B is equal to number of B cross A is equal to N of A into N of B. Now, we move to the solution. Given that A set and B set, what is A set? 1, 3, 5. What is B set? 2, 3. The first one, A cross B. So, already we used the Cartesian product. So, write in the ordered set of ordered pair only. A and cross B. 1, 3, 5 cross 2, 3. So, we take the 1, 1, 2, 1, 3. Again, 3, 3, 2, 3, 3. Again, 5, 5, 2, 5, 3. It's the first set. Now, B cross A. B means 2, 3 and A means 1, 3, 5. So, 2, 2, 1. 2, 1, 2, 3, 2, 5. And take 3. 3, 1, 3, 3, 3, 5. So, second set. Now, check the two sets, A cross B set and a B cross B set and the Cartesian products. The first one is 1 comma 2. A cross B, the first set is ordered pair is 1 comma 2. the second one, B cross A, the ordered pair is 2, 1, is not equal. Again, the second A cross B, second one is 1, 3, B cross second one is 2, 3, so also is not equal. So, from 1 and 2, we conclude that A cross B not equal to B cross A. Okay, now third one, n of A cross B and n of B is equal to n of B cross A is equal to n of A into n of B. First, find out n of A and n of B. What do you mean by n of A? How many elements in the A set? How many elements in the B set? How many elements in the A cross B? How many elements in B cross A? Simple, the fourth thing. First one, n of A is equal to 3 only because 3 elements are there. Next one, n of B means only 2 numbers are there, so 2. N of A cross B is equal to only 6. N of B cross A also 6. So, we conclude n of A cross B also 6. N of B cross A equal to 6. But n of A 2, n of A 3, n of B 2. So, multiply those things, we get 3 2s are 6. So, everything is equal. Thus, n of A cross B is equal to n of B cross A is equal to n of A into n of B. Hence, it is proved. Now, we move to example 1.2. It's a very important sum. If A cross B also given, A cross B is equal to 3, 2, one pair, 3, 4, another pair, 5,2 is another pair, 5, 4. So, 4 sets are ordered pairs are given. Then find A and B. What is A set? What is B set? Now, we move to solution. So, what is given? A cross B also given. 3, 2, 3, 4, 5, 2, 5, 4. We have A is equal. What do you mean by A? A set. Set of all first coordinates of elements of A cross B. In a Cartesian product A cross B, what is the set in A? The first numbers are called set A. That means set of all first coordinates of elements of A cross B. Therefore, A equal to 3, 3, 5, 5. So, the numbers are doubling. So, write the one time only. So, set A equal to 3, 5. Okay. Next one. What is B? B is a second numbers in the coordinates of A cross B. The second elements of A cross B is called set B. So, B is equal to set of all second coordinates of elements of A cross B. So, the numbers are 2, 4, 2, 4, are also doubling. So, write the B set is equal to 2, 4 only. So, A set is 3, 5 and B set is 2, 4. So, it's a very important sum.